Well, good evening. You're on with your podcast host and your YouTube channel host. We just want to thank you for being a part of Big J. And you know what time it is. It's time to talk sports, news, and information. We're excited to be on again and bring you information which is conducive in your hearing. If you don't like the information, you can let us know also. But I want to talk about this young lady again. But I want to say, first of all, congratulations to those young ladies from Jamaica who did an amazing job again, as they did in Tokyo. You are to be celebrated because you are amazing. I want to talk about Sha'Carri Richardson again, because if you look up at my thumbnail, you'll see something that I have inscripted to the side that says you have to be humble in victory, and then you have to be gracious in defeat. The amazing thing about this is that the ability to be humble deals with the level of maturity of a person. And when you have a person that is this age, and I'm not making excuses, the race is over with, but I'm talking about behavior. There are some people who are 50, 60, 70, and yet they are very immature. But what you have here is a young lady, and I'm not going to make any excuses or anything like that, but whoever's around her needs to change, because her selected understanding is very, very immature. And let me give you what the word immature means. Not fully developed or grown, acting in a childish way, having or showing a lack of emotional maturity. And that's what we've seen. I do understand the loss of her mother, but she chose to run this race. I understand all of that. I understand what happened with the Olympics and not going to Tokyo. Now, I don't even know if going to Tokyo would have been the right thing. All right. But the act of just such immaturity, and another word for immaturity is perfection. And when you watch the Jamaican women run, you saw perfection. But consider what I mean when I'm saying perfection. Their perfection looked like this. They came out without the being flamboyant, and their perfection was all focused on one thing: not their hair, not their nails, not who was in the stand, not the television cameras, but it was the finish line. And when your focus is broken, you can never be as great as you are. And what we saw yesterday after the race, when she got on the camera, we saw that. So you can hear and see, I'm telling you, you can hear and see the level of immaturity. Why? Because there were so many inconsistencies in her closing argument. Because it's nothing but an argument or statement which you want those who follow you to believe. It's like writing a good paper to where the thesis presents your argument. So listen to her closing argument, and we'll discuss it afterwards. So coming to perform, yesterday, I do not know if you saw the interview when they were talking to her with all the people surrounding her. She said, it's showtime. I have to get ready for the show. Now, is the show getting ready to perform a part of the ability to deceive the crowd? Or is the performance of what we've seen out of the young ladies from Jamaica, to where they were completely focused and they were looking to change history and do things? See, when you don't have the umbrella of understanding, I love when I saw Elaine, when she looked up the entire time after the race and she was looking at the scoreboard to see what her mark was, and the way she celebrated, which was so much class. But we can see that the individual here never had that in mind, because her whole aspect of understanding is, I'm ready to perform. I'll be right back.
You want, because I'm here to stay. I'm not done. I'm the sixth fastest woman in this game ever. And can't nobody
see that's what got me right there. Now she comes out and says, and she makes the truth of it. At first, before when she won before the what you call it, the pre-trials, she said this: I'm the fastest woman in the world. Go back and look it up. Now she says that I'm the sixth fastest woman in the world. There's so many inconsistencies here. And what I'm saying, ladies and gentlemen, it is a lack of maturity. This is a very immature young lady. And when you listen to her talk, you would definitely understand why she is, why I'm not going to say why she was using the weed, man, but you would definitely understand why there's some inconsistencies in her life. And she needs help. She needs the right people around her, not people saying, oh, you're great, you're good, oh, you can do it. No, but she needs to be chastised in an adult matter. I hope you understand what that means. To where someone who cares about you comes and tells you the truth, whether you want to hear it or not. And that's what matters. I'll be right back.
I'm going to take that from me. Congratulations to the winners. Congratulations to the people that won. But then I returned back to the sport. I wanted to be able to come in before. I'm going to take that from me. Congratulations to the winners. Congratulations to the people that won. But then I returned back to the sport. I wanted to be able to come in before.
Having a month off, dealing with what all I was going through. Why did you race? If you knew you were the sixth fastest woman in the world, why build all the hype up and the drama as though you could beat these young ladies? So this wasn't myself, but a lot of people were thrown off by the narrative and by the inconsistency. But when you listen now, she knows that she should have never been on the same field with those women. So guess what? Something is something to this with the marijuana thing and not going to Tokyo. And then for you to pull out the 200? Oh, I'm not going to get embarrassed again. See, in the word team, there's no I. The acronym stands for Together, Everyone Achieves More. Well, there were other women in that meet yesterday that were part of the U.S. She never said a word about. And if the economics of it are that good to where you belittle other people and you forget other people, God bless you. But she really needs to grow up. She has a lot of growing up to do. And those and these are the words of Big J. You'll find our disclaimer in, thank you, Nye. You'll find our disclaimer in the description to where we only speaking what we believe and understand. And these words are our opinions. But she needs to grow up fast. And she needs to get that individual around her that can help her in that area of understanding. You don't curse at people or curse people out because you hit a block or you hit a road. So I want to say again, you've been on with Big J. And you know what time it is. And the last words that I want to say is be the best. And the best you will become. God bless you.
Installation in progress. The process ended successfully. Skynet system is ready to use.